Hi students, welcome to Evershine Coaching Center. Myself, Shah Faisal sir here. Dear students, today we are going to continue the chapter of science, electricity of class 10th. In the previous classes, as you all know, we have already completed the topic related to electric charge, electric current and potential difference. In this session, we are going to solve some basic problems related to these terminologies. Is this clear? Come, let we study the basic numericals of this chapter, electricity. Let's begin. See students, the first problem here is, the filament of an electric bulb draws a current of 0.4 ampere. Students, well, before you solve any problem, so please kindly read the entire question first. Condition number one. Condition number two, just read one line. From that, what you will understand, convert that into symbol. Means write the data. Just read one sentence. From that, collect the information. Make a small note of that particular sentence. Is this clear? I'll tell you how you are supposed to do that. First, let me read the entire question. The filament of an electric bulb draws a current of 0.4 ampere. Calculate the amount of charge flowing through the filament if the bulb glows for 2 hours. Also calculate the number of electrons passed. Is this clear? So first let me write the data. Solution. The filament of an electric bulb draws a current of 0.4 ampere. It means that how much current the filament bulb is consuming? That is 0.4 ampere. I is denoted as current. Next, what is the next topic? Calculate the amount of charge. We have to calculate the amount of charge. That's nothing but we need to find the value of Q. Flowing through the filament, if the bulb glows for 2 hours, he has given the time duration. What is the time? 2 hours. And dear students, listen to this concept very carefully. He has given in hours, we need to convert that into seconds. Okay? ये hours में दिया गया है, हमारे को इसको seconds में convert करना है. Understood? So for that what we do, we multiply 2 into 60. अगर से आप 2 को 60 से multiply करेंगे, तो वो minutes में convert होगा. 2 in the 60 के multiply मारते, एन value कोटी दरे 2, अधिके यावदादरु value इरली, अधिके 60 in the multiply मारते, अधु minutes नल convert आगोते. Again, if you multiply with one more 60, then it converts into seconds. Is this clear? So 2 into 60 is 120, 120 into 60 is 7200 seconds. So the duration of time is 7200. Now also calculate the number of electrons passed. It means that we need to find the value of N. Done? Good. Now see children. Here we have to find the values of two values. One is Q and other one is N. Children, he has given I, right? See, this is the hint. He has given the value of I. And we have T. Is this clear? We know the value of I. We know the value of T. Hence, we know the value of I and T. To find Q, we have the formula. That is, I is equals to Q by T. Understood? Electric current is nothing but charge by charge upon time. That is, I is equals to Q by T. Now what we need to find? We need to find the value of Q. So Q is equals to I into T. Cross multiply this T. Understood? We want Q. So keep Q as it is. Multiply I with T. That's nothing but the what is the value of I? 0.4 into time. That's nothing but 7200. Understood children? Then multiply 0.4 into 7200. Then we get the value as 2800. So what is the value of Q? 2800. Always remember the charge is denoted by the symbol coulomb. That is nothing but C. So C is the SI unit of charge. That is Q. So what is the Q value now we have found? 2800 coulomb. Next what we need to find? We need to find the number of electrons passed. It means N value we need to find. To find N value, we have the formula that is N is equals to Q by E. So, what is the value of, how to find the value of N? if not, if I hope you can remember this formula, Q equals N into E. Yeah, from this formula we have derived this. So Q is equals to N into E. That's nothing but N equals Q by E. So what is charge? It's been found. Right now we have found the value of Q, that is 2800 by electron. Means what is the value of E? We know the value of E is 1800 into 10 to the power of 19. Is this clear? The value of E is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19. So this is the value of E. So shall we substitute the value of E? 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19. So this value is constant. The value of E is constant, that is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. Now what we do here, we just divide this 2800 divided by 1.6. Is this clear? So how much will be the value we get? We get 1800. If you want, you can divide this 2800 divided by 1.6. You can calculate this value in working column. You will be getting the answer as 1800 into this 10 raised to minus 19. If it comes to the numerator, it becomes 10 to the power of plus 19. Always remember, if it is minus 19, it becomes plus 19. If denominator is plus 19, then it becomes minus 19. Is this clear? Good. That is nothing but 1800 into 10 to the power of 19. If you want to keep in decimals, then if you want 1.8, okay, 1.8 into 10 to the power of 22, it becomes 1.8 into 10 to the power of 92. So this is the value of N. Is this clear? How much number of electrons has passed? That is 1.8 into 10 to the power of 22. If not, you can write as 1800 into 10 to the power of 19. You can keep the value there as it is. So this is the number of electrons passed. I hope you all have understood this problem. Is this clear? The problem is simple. So this type of problem can be asked for 2 marks. Is this clear? Good. Now, dear students, before we solve the next problem, I just like to tell you that if you have not subscribed our channel, so please you can subscribe our YouTube channel, Evershine Coaching Groups. This is our YouTube channel. Is this clear? Good. And do not forget in the last, after the end of this session, to like this video or any of our videos after you watch it. And do not forget to comment below how was this session and how much useful it was for you. Done. And you can share this video to your other friends. Let they also utilize the opportunity to study with Faisal sir. Thank you. Now let we solve the next problem. Next problem, question number 2. Calculate the work done in moving a charge of 2 coulomb through a potential difference of 5 volt. See children, what is the question here? Calculate the work done means how much amount of work you are going to do to move a charge of 2 coulomb. Okay, we are moving a charge of 2 coulomb and it has the potential difference of 5 volt. Is this clear? So to move a charge of 2 coulomb and potential difference 5 volt, how much we are going to do the work? That is nothing but we have to calculate the work done. That's nothing but W. Okay, and he has given the value of charge, that is 2 coulomb, and potential difference V is 5 volt. Done. Children, we know that V is equals to W by Q, correct? So this is the standard formula to find the potential difference. Potential difference is capital V and small letter V is volt. Okay, that's nothing but V is equals to W by Q is equals to what? Actually, what we want to find, we want to find the value of W. So keep W as it is, then V into Q. So what is the formula to find W? W is equals to V into Q. That's nothing but W is equals to, that's work done is equals to V. How much potential difference? 5 volt into charge, that is 2 coulomb. That's nothing but 5 into 2, that is 10. So how much is work done? 10. Work done is denoted by the SI unit, joules. Is this clear? So how much work done to move a charge of 2 coulomb and potential difference 5 volt? That is 10 joules. Is this clear? Good. Now let me solve the next problem. See children, the next problem. A polythene piece is wrapped with wool. It is found to acquire a negative charge of 3.2 into 10 raised to minus 7 coulomb. Estimate the number of electrons transferred to the piece. See children, here the question is, a polythene piece is rubbed with wool. One polythene do, one piece ide, andre one batte antkoli. Adna ven martidivi, wool jote rub martidivi. Ek polythene ke kapde ko hum wool ke kapde se ya wool ke jo bhi cheez hai usse hum kya kar rahe hain, dono ko rub kar rahe hain. We are rubbing polythene piece with wool. Once we rub with each other, definitely the electrons will produce. So it is found to acquire a negative charge of 3.2 into 10 raised to minus 7 coulomb. So this much charge is developed in that. Okay. Now here what we have to calculate is number of electrons. So how many number of electrons has transferred to the piece? Jab hum ek cheez ko dusri cheez se rub karenge to electrons transfer honge. Yavaga naavu one vastuvige innond vastuvinda yavaga erdukkunu ಸಮವಾಗಿ ಯಾವಾಗ ನಾವು ಆಪೋಸಿಟ್ ಸೈಡ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ರಬ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಆವಾಗ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅದು ಎಷ್ಟು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅದು ನಾವು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಓಕೆ ನಾವು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ ವಿ ರೈಟ್ ದ ಡೇಟಾ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಟು ಅಕ್ವೈರ್ ಎ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಆಫ್ 3.2 ಕೂಲುಂ ಸಿ ಸಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಕೂಲುಂ ಕೂಲುಂ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಸೊ ಕ್ಯೂ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಈಸ್ 3.2 × 10⁻⁷ ಕೂಲುಂ ಸಿ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಸಿ ಸಿ ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ Now what we need to find? We need to find the value of N. That is nothing but number of electrons. Okay? Children, as you all know it, we have the formula that is Q is equals to N into E. Can you remember this formula? Q is equals to N into E. So this is our standard formula. Now what we need to find here? We need to find the value of N. So N is equals to Q by E. Q by E. So keep n as it is, e cross multiply, e will comes down, so it becomes q by e. That's nothing but what is the value of q? 3.2 into 10 to the power of minus 7. And then what is the value of e? As I said you, the value of e is constant, that is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19. Is this clear? The electron value is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19. That's nothing but 1.6 into 10 10 to the power of minus 19. Done? See children. Now here we can see the value 3.2 1.6. See here. 3.2 by 1.6. See both are having a single decimal. Right? Both are having a single decimal. Let it be. You 1.6 you assume as 16. 16 ones are 16 twos are. Right? So it is 0.1 and it is 0.2. 0.2 by 0.1 is 0.2. It's nothing but, now we can write here 0.2 into 10 to the power of minus 7 into 10 to the power of plus 19. See children, if this minus 19 goes up, it becomes plus 19. This is already 10 raised to minus 7 is in the numerator. So it remains as it is, but this minus 19 comes up, so it becomes plus 19. Done? That's nothing but 0.2 into 10 to the power of 19 minus 7. How much children? In 19, if you subtract 7, what is the value? That's nothing but 2. That's nothing but just a minute. Yeah, 19 minus 7 is 10 to the power of plus 12. Sorry. Children, here it's 1.6 ones are 1.6 twos are, it is nothing but 2, it's not 0.2, it is 2. Okay, it's nothing but 2 into, just a minute, 2 into 10 to the power of 12. Is this clear? So 1.6 ones are, 1.6 into 2, 2 6 are 12, 2 ones are 2 plus 1 3 point, that's nothing but 3.2. So 1.6 ones are, 1.6 twos are, it is 3.2. So the value of n is 2 into 10 to the power of 12. So this is the number of electrons transferred to the piece. Any doubts? Is this clear? Good. If you want, you can do one more thing. I can tell you 1.6 by, I mean 3.2 I'm telling you. 3.2 by 1.6 was there, no? See, 3.2. It means after one digit, we have decimal. So, we can write as 32 and here we can write as 16. See, point we are removing here also. Point we are removed here also. 3.2 can we write as 32. Then 1.6 can also be written as 16. So, 16 ones are 16 twos are. Is this clear? This is another method of this type of calculation. Okay, now let me solve the next problem. See children, the next problem here is, how many electrons pass through a wire in 1 minute if the current passing through the wire is 200 milliampere? See children, here question is, how many number of electrons, how many means number of electrons. Okay, it means we need to find the value of N. Number of electrons, how many means number of electrons we need to find. Pass through a wire in 1 minute. So what is the time? Time is given in minutes. So what I said you, we have to convert into seconds. So 1 into 60, that's nothing but 60 seconds time. If the current passing through the wire is, how much current is passed in the wire? 200 milliampere. 200 milliampere. So here we need to write the value of in terms of ampere. We want to convert this milli. So we can write this as 200 into 10 to the power of minus 3 ampere. 200 into 10 to the power of minus 3. If you want to remove this m, then you have to put minus 3. 10 raised to minus 3. So if you write this 10 raised to minus 3, if you want to remove that, then you can write as 0.2 ampere. See children, 200 into 10 to the power of minus 3. See, if you want to remove minus, so you have to keep the digit after 3. Here, what is the value here? Minus 3 means 3. So 1, 2, 3. Here, you have to keep the point. Leaving 3 digits. 10 raised to minus 3 means leave 3 digits from right hand side and keep the point. Understood? If it was minus 2, then what happens? 200 into 10 raised to minus 2 means after 2 digits. That's nothing but 200, no? After 2 digits means it comes here. So it becomes 2.00. If it is minus 3, point will come here. If it is minus 1, it becomes 20. Understood, children? Minus means you have to decrease. Minus 1 means leave 1 digit and keep the point. Minus 2 means leave 2 digits and keep the point. Minus 3 means leave 3 digits and keep the point. Is this clear? Again, I will show you. This you have to be very much careful. 200 into 10 raised to minus 1 comes means what you should do for 200? After 1 digit, keep the point. If it is same thing, 200 into 10 raised to minus 2. So, 200 as it is, after 2 digits, you keep the point. So, it is 20.0, it becomes 20. 2.00, it becomes 2. Same way, 200 into 10 raised to minus 3 means 200 after 3 digits. 1, 2, 3. Keep the point here. Here, nothing is there. Number means we have to write as 0. That's nothing but 0.2. Understood what is the meaning of minus 1, minus 2, minus 3? Yes, you should not forget these values. So, these are the basic things before you solve any problem. Okay, good. See children, he has given I and he has given T and he is asking us to find N. Okay, now since he has given I and T, so what we can do? We know that I is equals to Q by T. This is our standard formula. Okay, but here we are not finding Q. But what is Q? We know that Q is equals to N into E. So, in place of Q, can we write N into E divided by T. So, from this we have derived that I is equals to N into E by T. We want N. So, what we do? We keep this N as it is. We keep this N as it is. Rest of the term shift to the other side. So, what happens? N is equals to I into T, cross multiply this T here, I into T by E. So, this E will comes down, this T will goes up. Understood children? Is this clear? Good. So, now what is the value of N? The value of N is I into T by E. That's nothing but the value of I is how much? 0.2. The value of T is 60. And what is E? Can you tell me what is the value of E? Yes, it's constant value, right? E is equals to 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19. So, 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19. Got it? See children, I'll tell you one more thing. See again, 0.2, 1.6. So what we can do? 0.2 and here is 1.6. Leave one digit, leave one digit. So it becomes 2 and here it becomes 16. 0.2. Understood? After one digit here, even after one digit here means 0.2 by 1.6. One digit means multiply by 10. Here also multiply this by 10. 0.2 into 10, it becomes, see here, 0.2 into 10, 0, 0, 1, 2, 0, 1, 0, 0, 2, 0. So after one digit, keep point. 0, 0, 2.0, it's nothing but 2. 1.6 into 10, you see, 1.6 into 10, 0, 0, 1, 6, 1, 1, 0, 6, 1. Leave one digit and keep. That's nothing but 16. Understood? That's what we have written here in shortcut. Here we have left one digit right side. This point I'm shifting to the right side, it becomes 2. Again, this point shift to the right side, it becomes 16. Got it? So this is the other method to do this type of calculation. Understood? Now let's see what we have to do. Now 0.2 into 60. If you want, you can multiply this value directly, 0.2 into 60, then divide by 1.6. Okay, if you want, you can do that. If not, what you can do is, see here, 0.2 will becomes 2 into 60. 1.6 will become 16 into 10 raised to minus 9. Correct? No, 2 ones are 2 eights are. Correct? Same way, next. 2 fours are, 2 threes are, this 0, right? Next, same way, 4 ones are, 4 sevens are, point, 2 4 fives are 20. So, what is the value? 7.5 by 10 raised to minus 19. It becomes 7.5, the value of n is 7.5 into 10 to the power of plus 19. Understood? If you want, you can do this calculation once again. 0.2 by 1.6 into 60 by 10 raised to minus 9. So the value of n is how many electrons are passed in the wire? 7.5 into 10 to the power of 19 electrons is passed in this type of wire, in this wire. Understood? So you have to be very much careful with this type of calculations. Done? Good. Now let me solve the next problem. Yes, children, the next problem here we can see 2.5 millijoules of work is done in moving a charge of 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb from one point to another. What is the potential difference between the two points? See, children, this much amount of work is done to move a charge of 10 raised to minus 6 coulomb. 2.5 millijoules of work is done. ಇತ್ನ ಹಮ್ ಕಾಮ್ ಕರ್ರೆ ಇಷ್ಟು ನಾವು ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಇಷ್ಟು ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಗೆ ಒಂದ್ ಜಾಗದಿಂದ ಇನ್ನೊಂದ್ ಜಾಗಕ್ಕೆ ಶಿಫ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಮಜ್ ಮೇ ಆ ಬೇಟಾ ಹಮ್ 2.5 ಮಿಲಿ ಜೋಲ್ಸ್ ಉತ್ನ ಕಾಮ್ ಕರ್ರೆ 10 power ಮೈನಸ್ 6 ಕೂಲಂ ಉತ್ನ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಕು ಏಕ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಸೆ ದೂಸರೆ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಕು ಶಿಫ್ಟ್ ಕರ್ನೆ ಕೆ ಲಿಯೆ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟೂಡ್ ಸೋ ನೌ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪೊಟೆನ್ಶಿಯಲ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಟೂ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ So between these two points, what is the potential difference? See, the problems are very simple, children. Easily people can score 2 to 3 marks from this type of problems. Okay. So how much is the work done? That is, work done is 2.5 millijoules. But always we have to keep the work in joules. So we want to remove this small letter M. So what we should do? 2.5 into 10 to the power of 10 to the power of minus 3. If you want to remove M, you have to write 10 power minus 3 joules. So this is the amount of work is done. To move a charge of how much coulombs? 10 to the power of minus 6 coulomb. Now we have to calculate potential difference. That is nothing but V. Children, to find potential difference, we have the formula, that is V is equals to W by Q. V is equals to W by Q. So how much is work is done? 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 3 by how much charge? 10 to the power of minus 6. So now we can see here 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 3. This 10 power minus 6 comes to the numerator, it becomes 10 to the power of plus 6. Right? So now we can say that 2.5 into 6 minus 3, 10 as it is, bases are same, we have to add the powers. 6 minus 3 is plus 3. So what is the final answer? Potential difference is 2.5 into 10 to the power of 3 volt, small letter V. So this is the potential difference. I hope you all have understood this problem. Fine. See here children, the next question. Question number 6. 2 ampere of current is flowing through a wire. What is the amount of charge passing through it in 1 minute? Also find the number of electrons passed through a cross section of wire in this time. You can try this problem. And next question. An electric bulb draws a current of 0.5 ampere for 10 minutes. Calculate the amount of electric charge that flows through the circuit. Next question. Calculate the number of electrons constituting 1 coulomb of charge. So, you can solve these 3 problems. Okay. By using the same method as what we have done in before cases, you can apply the same method and the formulas to solve these 3 problems. I hope you all have understood this concept. Dear students, I just want to tell you one more thing. You can just please make a note of one small questions. Okay, the theory questions which is related to this topic. Please make a note. Question number 1. You can expect the theory questions. Okay, please make a note of it. First question. Please copy down this properly. Yeah. Is this clear? I hope you have copied these questions. Good. Define option A. Electric potential, these are the theory questions. Define option A, electric potential, option B, 1 volt, option C, electric current, option D, 1 ampere. Next question. What is an electric circuit? What is an electric circuit? Question mark. Write the symbols of electrical components. Write the symbols of electrical components. Next question. Differentiate between voltmeter and ammeter. Voltmeter and ammeter. Next question. Draw the following electrical symbols. Next line. Option A. Battery. Option A. Battery. Option B, plug key in closed condition. Plug key in closed condition. Option C, variable resistance. Option D, electric bulb. Is this clear? Okay. Next question. What is the potential difference? What is the potential difference between two points in the electric field? In the electric field. Question mark. Name and define. Name and define its SI unit. Name and define its SI unit. Okay. Next question. How much energy is given to each coulomb of charge passing through a 6-volt battery. Passing through a 6-volt battery. Okay. Passing through a 6-volt battery. Next question. Define the SI unit of electric current and potential difference. Okay, children, you can try solving these questions. I hope you all have understood this topic, the numericals and important questions which is related to this first concept of electric current and potential difference. So thank you for watching this video. Wish you all the best of luck. Do well. Do not forget to subscribe our YouTube channel to find still more the latest videos and updates. Okay, you can click the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Okay, so please do not forget to like, click the like button, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you for watching this video.